Can Xcode vibe code? I wanted to find out. So I downloaded the beta of macOS 26 and installed the newest Xcode. The new Xcode has a ChatGPT integration built into the IDE. You can also choose to use API access for other models like Claude, as well as if you want specific OpenAI models. If you use the default ChatGPT, it's going to go behind the scenes and pick one. I think it's using the 4.0 model, and that may change. And at the moment, there's no way to change the ChatGPT model you're using unless you switch over to API. And once you're all set up, you have this chat window inside of Xcode that you converse with. So I thought I'd pick something simple like a weather app and see how this works. And pretty much as you'd expect, you describe what you're looking to do. In this case, I wanted, you know, just a simple weather display on a minimalist kind of gradient background. And the process is iterative, and you just keep asking it to make changes. The idea of vibe coding is that you don't really touch the code at all, if you're being true to the term. And so I did not write a single line of code, I don't think, for this entire project. I basically just kept asking the AI to make changes. Now, one of the things that's cool about this integration, and this is not going to be earth-shattering to people who have been using tools like Cursor, is that Xcode now has access to as much about your project as you want to give it access to. And so that means it will be able to see the error states apparently in Xcode. It will have access across the project to all the different files. And you can see that this is just kind of coming along. I've asked it to do things like use a metal shader to create a animated gradient in the background. You can drop screenshots in if you don't like the way the layout's looking and you want to be more clear with the AI on what you're seeing on the screen. And the other thing is it's beta, so things stop working and you've got to restart the app, but you know, whatever. I decided we should use some actual data at this point. So I'd said, you know, are there APIs where we can be pulling this weather information from rather than just using this mock data? So it was able to use its knowledge to just go out and find a public API and plug that in. And then I was like, well, can we change this a bit so that the weather icons match the time of day? Because it's nighttime in Paris right now, and it went and it matched the SF symbols to the time of day, which at first was a little buggy given UTC time, and then it sorted that out when I corrected it. So it was coming along, you know, this was like no code. And so last finishing touches, I decided to make the list on the left actually scrollable, interactive, a little bit of a gradient fall off at the bottom there. And I figured one last nice thing would be to add the ability to add new cities into the app. So once again, asked it to find a free public API we could hit for that. And you can actually type in a city and add that to your list. So that's where it ended up. There's a lot more you could do for an app like this, but pretty successful experiment, especially for a day zero beta. And so that's vibe coding in Xcode.